My name is Fatima Kelawi. I'm a teaching artist with the Hawaii State Foundation. I'm on the roster, so I created this project looking at my practice as a nomad artist. I travel and invite people to embroider a piece all over the world, and I like to engage students in the practice. I was at Moanalua High School the year before and in discussion with a teacher in high school, and I was volunteering at RISE, and I noticed the kids wearing the backpack. And my, because I'm volunteer at RISE, the youth wearing the backpack as well. And because I'm a fiber art artist, talking with the teacher, Mr. Kalma, I was like, well, maybe we should do something on the residency, because we were planning to do the residency. And that was my first year as a teaching artist with Hawaii State Foundation. So it started from there, and I was able to do like, invite the student to understand the process of what it is to use fiber art, to invite people to look at different ways and look at young, being young and homeless in Hawaii. And starting from their experience, of course, like what do they know as a student, what do they know about being young and homeless? Starting from them, and then we deconstruct, and then we learn some skills. So we have like, they call each other, it's like, we're doing omek. Absolutely, it is omek. It is part of your life as well. And yeah, from there, it was very nice to guide them separately and telling them that they were working on the same piece to in parallel, just to make sure that they were having each other's back. So 84 students working on as a pair on one backpack, and 16 of the young and homeless youth from RISE work like in two different shelters with me on their piece. So translating the reality, the other one about what it is to be young and homeless. From all of the information, from discussion, from RISE education team visiting us, giving us information, continuously building and noticing also that's not just Hawaii problem, it's a United States problem. So on my work, I always try to have the kids, and they were English honor students, so I was very lucky to have very eager to read, eager to look at different ways of studying English, and to get those process all together, and making sure that they understood what was the art advocacy, and yeah, they were very engaged. At the end, it was fabulous to see like the achievement of the backpack, and then they were first at the HISAM, at Hawaii State Foundation, now it's Capital Modern. Thanks to the Hawaii State Foundation, the group never meet, because I didn't want the, one of the constraints was like, the young don't want to be just stigmatized and known as homeless. They're working, they take the bus, nobody knows. Sometimes they're at some shop and they're serving you and they are homeless, but the backpack is really helping them to kind of like blend in, being very invisible. So I wanted to make sure I keep that. And even when I did the opening of the RISE, I invited the RISE separately. The Moanalua students separately visited. So 84 students took the bus and went to the Hawaii State Foundation. And I'm at the end, when we finished the residency, it's like, okay guys, we did the work. Now it's not finished yet. I need to try to see if we can try to show it, because it's important work, people are connecting. Hawaii community are reacting very positively. Maybe we try to show it somewhere else, and I guess the state capital is the best place to be to kind of like engage with all of the community, the legislator. And when I put it up on March 12th, thanks to Toby and Senator Kidani and superintendent, it was it was a very good opportunity. So it's been nice, and it's been nice to be able to kind of like engage in conversation here. It's such an important place for Hawaii, hopefully. And I know how people like, and it's non-confrontational. That's what I like about fiber art. It's inviting. It's inviting to conversation. That's my finger. I come to them for, I've been with them for 5 years. Mm-hmm. So I built a relationship with RISE. RISE is a new organization that takes care of, it's a residential education services for youth experiencing homelessness. So this young Asian organization, when I heard Carla Hauser on radio, I was like, I need to be there. because my focus is always marginalized people, because my background is Arabic. Post 9/11, I was afraid of it, and I suddenly changed my statue and my world changed living here in the United States. I was not living here. So being marginalized, trying to be invisible, is important for people trying to survive. So I connect with them, and I always stick them wherever I am. I did a lot of move around, like even in Panama, I'm trying to do a rest stick. That's my I'm a nomad, that's what it is. And now I've been here in Hawaii for 10 years. So 5 years of this, been in and out, and when I can, I work, I do all of the things that I need to do. But being there for those kids was always great. And I cook, you know, I talk stories, I cry, I visit the babies. So there's a trust. I took them to a museum. The Hawaii State Foundation was the first place where I was able to take them and say, like, hey, do you mind? I'm going to bring some young people. They might not be your typical visitors, but let's try. Took them to the bishop. And I tried little experience, but at their level, when they were ready. Always adapting because, you know, it's rice, kids. Drama is part of the being young and homeless in Hawaii. It's, and they're in and out, so they disappear. Like, for example, this one, she doesn't talk. So I shared what I was going to do. They were totally on board. And she didn't talk. She's a day visitor. So there's people that are coming to for help, and people who are coming are staying there. And she loved to paint. So I bought all of the supplies. I carried those things and all that. And yeah, in one setting, I call it my Van Gogh backpack. And this one has, of course, there's a lot of issues. And I'm just talking about the rice people I can point out. Not just housing. If it was just housing, it would be easier. We just put them in an apartment and done. But there's also like struggle with mental illness, trauma. She worked like constantly, 2 months. Every time I brought the sick, it changed. So none of the kids have successful story, because it's an ongoing struggle. And what I love is that so many are exceeded because there's some issues, you know, like it would be nice if everything would be happy story at the end. But they believe in the project. They totally believe, they're just so proud. Every time I say to them, like, guess what? The backpack are going there. I could see the smile. Almost I had like some people coming, like last week with one that I was able to catch, to come and see it. But they're shy. They're also thinking like, well, I don't want people to recognize me if I'm working, if I'm on the street, if I go to a nightclub. I don't want people to say, hey, I saw you somewhere. And I thought I'd get that. And the student absolutely got that. They were so cool when I had those 84, we had the conversation. And when I was leaving them, just like, tell them, we care about them. Tell them we're their champion. And they told me, like, keep the backpack, as long as people want to see them, we want them to be with you. So I'm pretty much the carrier of their peace.
Okay, good morning. I'm Toby Portner, and I work for the Department of Education in Hawaii as the coordinator for the Education for Homeless Children and Youth program. It's a national program. There's one in every state, and a coordinator to identify kids whose housing is unstable, kids and their families, and remove barriers to their full participation in school. And the program's been around since 1986. And it changes over the decades along with the needs that are identified in the community. And we are here to make sure that the kids have what they need to get through school successfully and that the systems are there to support them as time moves forward. We have, as of this morning, about 5,300 kids across the state that are identified in unstable housing. That includes doubling up with friends and family due to economic hardship. That's true across the nation. That's part of the definition of homelessness for education and not for HUD. And that leaves a lot of families ineligible for support around housing. And so we are there to lift them up, to make sure that they have supplemental transportation to get to school, to have the supplies that they need, to have supplemental tutoring, to put an extra layer of support on top of what the kids get in school and bridge community and school. Well, we work closely with RISE, which is the youth shelter, and somehow we found out that this project was happening and that they were having an opening display at the Capitol Modern, what we now call the Capitol Modern. And so I went and I met Fatia there and learned about her work and was just fascinated by the idea that art lets us have discussions about hard things that we wouldn't have without it. And so I just was part of that opening that night, listening to how people engage and the questions that they asked, and we just committed to working together to bring this to as many places as we can. So then I reached out to our policy team in the department and said, hey, there's this opportunity to display it, and they made the connection here at the Capitol. So then I introduced Fatia to Mary from Senator Kidani's office, and it just kind of spiraled from there. I mean, really, I'm a liaison for it. You know, that this is this tool that helps us have conversations with people so that we can build partnerships, so that we can have sustainable systems for our families that are struggling with housing, and their kids can get through school successfully. And this helps us do that. It's like the lubricant for the dialogue. You know, and so we're grateful for it. And we're grateful to you for coming together to look at problems that are real in the community that they are soon to be adults in, and to give them opportunities to dialogue with each other when it's possible or through the art, and come up with solutions. And in the EHCY program that I was talking about, Education for Homeless Children and Youth, there's this subset that we pay attention to.